Hello everyone, welcome to Fallen Tutorials, and today I'm going to start a new tutorial how to make a 2D platformer game in Unity. We are going to make this game from scratch in Unity, and I'm going to cover as many steps as possible. So first we're going to build this game for PC, and we try to convert this game for mobile by giving mobile inputs, and then we also going to print some small simple ads. And in the end of the tutorial, your game going to ready to publish in any platforms like Google Play Store, Apple, and itch.io. So let's do some setup first. The assets that we're going to use is Pixel Platform from Kenney store. I will give the link in the description, or you can also use your own assets if you want. There's no restriction on the assets, but just they used to be 2D. Okay, I'm in the Unity projects, and I've just empty default projects here. So here the hard window is inspector and project window. So if you already done, if you downloaded assets, so we plan to import it first. So I'm going using, as I said, I'm going to use Kenney as a store for the assets. So I'm using Pixel Art platform. I give the link in description. So I'm going to put only four things, not a four, only three things: background, character, and all the tiles. They are necessary. Then I will just drag and drop this folder here. Okay, our assets are imported correctly. So next thing I'm going to tell you about that there's this main camera. Now main camera has a camera components. Now every game object has some properties, so as we call them components. So let's first drag this our player into the scene. So we're going to use characters, and we have a bunch of characters. So I'm thinking of using this character as a main player. So just drag drop in hard window, and it's all coming up here. Now it's looking, our character is looking blurry. So to fix it, I'm going to going to decrease the pixel per unit first. So I'm going to decrease the pixel per unit by 16, I think is a good option, and hit apply. So it's become big, and that's what I needed. So still is blurry. So to, and another thing, we're going to go to filter mode. Now in filter mode, I'm going to set point no filter and hit apply. When you're working with pixel art, this option is best, and hit, we have a very clear image come here. Now we're going to do this with all images, the rest of the images. So select all of them and decrease the pixel per unit of 16 and use the point and apply, and everything going to fix it. If I'm going to drag on another, so it's going to have another, so everything picture looking very correctly. Now do the same with the tiles. So go tiles, and we're going to select all the tiles at once, decrease the by 16 pixel per unit. Remember, the less the pixels, the less a pixel per unit, the more larger the image, and the more the pixel per unit, the more smaller the image. So just use point no filter and hit apply. It's going to take some time because there are lots of the tiles here. And if you're going to drag any tiles, I think this one, so it has, it look clear, this one too, and any everything. So first thing I'm going to drag on this one, good. So next thing I'm going to put the characters, and if you look character, they have two components: transform component and sprite render component. Now sprite render is responsible for rendering the sprites in Unity. So, and there's a bunch of settings you can play out. They have colors, so you can also edit the colors, but having white color is a good, is right for now. And also the ordering layer, we deal ordering layer for further in the videos, and also the sorting layers when we're going to create the maps. Okay, so leave the settings in now. And we're going to add a new component that is going to be a rigid body. That rigid body is going to enable the physics for our the game objects. So here's a bunch of settings. I'm going to think of leaving the setting as a default as I can. And also going to play the game. This is for testing window. Game, we'll go to the game and test window. It look is our character going to falling down. This is because due to the gravity. We enable the physics, so gravity also going to enable. Then next thing, I'm going to add a box slider to the game. Not a bad slider, but it's not a good idea. I'm going to add a cylinder, a capsule one, capsule glider 2D. It's a characterizing thing. And going to do some changes out there. Edit the collider. And I think this looks really good. So just the collider, what going to do is going to enable collisions. So first thing, we need a collisions. We need another game object too. So I'm going to add the ground. So let's drag in the ground here first and go to the down here. I'm going to press control and going to snap to the grids. And the settings for the snapping is here. You can edit the value of the snaps. Yeah, so you, I'm going to increment the value 0.25 per move when I move the character. So look, so let's drag them here and somewhat here. I'm not going to create a map now. This is for just a basic structure. And drag the next one somewhat here. Somewhat here. Now if I play, we have a ground object first of game still fall down. And you also notice one more thing I'm going to show you. Like if I play and just try to pause immediately and just pause, look, our player go behind the ground. So here's the one main thing, audience leg come to action. Now if you're going to increase audience, it's going to come forward, and so decrease the go background. So audience layer do the, these things. We can arrange the 2D game with some orders in layers. So having 0 for now this default, we does not go deal. Having 1 is now great idea. So next thing, okay, still we need to add some colliders. So just set all of them. I'm going to add a box collider to all the grounds. And what's going to do is it's going to enable collision. And now if we play, our player does not go through the grounds. Look, it does not go into the grounds and is standing on it. So it means is this thing is working. Our glide is working. Now our player does not do anything. We need to add some scripts to form movements. And that's thing we're going to deal in our next video. For till now, I think it's just a setup and introduction video for this platformer game. And if you're really distracted by this tutorial, you can subscribe the channel. And if you want to support the channel, you can also join my Patreon. And thanks for watching.